EMF in rotating conducting rod in a uniform magnetic field. EMF induced is given by rate of change of flux. So we can change the flux by different method. One is by rotating, other is by increasing, decreasing turns or field or area. So here we are assuming a conducting rod having length L placed in uniform magnetic field of induction B. Field is inward. Induction B bar. And turned by angle D theta. And brought to the position P to Q. This angle is supposed D theta. Just draw the diagram. What is length of arc formula? Is it L D theta? S equal to R theta means L D theta?
Yes.
Just copy this one. Diagram drawn?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We are interested in induced EMF. So consider a conducting rod of length L to be revolved perpendicular to the magnetic field. Very important for MCQ, this one. To a magnetic field B. Perpendicular to magnetic field B with uniform angular velocity omega about end O. Let OP be the position of rod at any instant. Let in time dt second it be rotated to new position OQ, rotated by angle D theta. Therefore, area swept by rod in time dt. What is area of sector formula? Half LR. Do you know this? Area of sector is half LR. Okay, just write. If you don't know this, I'm explaining. Write down this much. Done, Paul?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Just tell me if this is circle, what is this part called as? Arc?
Yes.
What is relation between this arc and this? S equal to R theta? Or we can say length of arc is R theta. And this part which is enclosing area is called sector. This is called sector. For full circle, what is area? Is it pi r square? Full circle area is pi r square. So when angle is 2 pi radian, then area is pi r square. Angle is theta, then area will be theta into pi r square upon 2 pi. This is called area of sector. Pi pi cancel. Area of sector is half r into r theta. Now r theta is nothing but this length of arc. So I can say area of sector is half into length of arc into radius. Okay?
Yes.
So area swept by the rod in time dt, comma dA is half into radius, which is length of that rod, into arc length, which is L d theta. Correct? This you followed? Half radius into arc, half LR. Since A equal to half LR. LR means length of arc into radius. Hello?
Yes.
I'm writing the formula, otherwise it will lead to confusion. DA equals to half into length of arc into radius. Therefore, dA is half into length of arc L d theta into radius L. So dA equals to half L square d theta. Therefore, rate of change of magnetic flux. Rate of change of magnetic flux. Comma d phi by dt equals to b into dA by dt. Rate of change of flux associated with coil is b into dA by dt. Okay, copy this much again. Done.
Yes, sir.
Okay. d phi by dt is d da. I'm just putting the value. We got ds half l square d theta. So it will be b da is half l square d theta upon dt. That is half b l square d theta by dt is omega by Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction induced EMF, comma E is rate of change of flux. So it will become E equals to half B L square omega. One general formula is d phi by dt. Moving rod then BLV. Rotating rod then half B L square omega. Done.
Yes.
So we have three formula for EMF induced. First, E equals to d phi by dt. Second, d by dt of flux is nothing but number of turns into area into B. Third, E is BLV, here B bar, L bar, B bar are mutually perpendicular. And half B L square omega. Solve. All right, done note.
Yes.
Okay. Self induction. The phenomenon of EMF induced in the coil by changing current in the same coil is called as self-induction. Phenomenon of EMF induced in the coil by changing current in the same coil is called as self-induction. Let
phi b flux per ton associated with coil of n turns carrying current I. Therefore, total flux is directly proportional to current flow. That means N phi is Li, where L is a constant called as coefficient. Okay, please copy this one. Phenomenon of EMF induced in the coil by changing current in the same coil is called self-induction. So if phi is flux per turn, total flux will be N phi due to current I. So to remove that proportionality sign, we have written L, where L is constant called as coefficient of induction.
Yes.
That means we can say L equals to N phi due to magnet N phi upon current I. If I equal to 1 ampere, then L equals to N phi. So actually self inductance is nothing but flux only. So we can say hence coefficient of self inductance is equal to the number of flux linked with coil. Number of flux linked with coil when current of 1 ampere flows through coil. Its SI unit is Henry, denoted by H.
Yes, sir.
By Faraday's and Lenz's law equals to minus n d phi by d equals to d by dt of n phi. Therefore, E equals to minus d by dt of L, d phi by dt is Li. So, E equals to L constant di by dt. That means this is formula for induced EMF if current flows through a coil of N turns. From this, you can say L will be minus of E upon di by dt. If di by dt is 1 ampere per second, then L equals to minus E. Thus, self inductance is also defined as self-induced EMF in the coil. Say one was flux linked with the coil per unit current. Second, you can say self-inductance is also defined as self-induced EMF in the coil when current changes in the coil at the rate of 1 ampere per second. Copy from here.
Yes, sir.
The self-inductance is also defined as self-induced EMF in the coil when current changes in the coil at the rate of 1 ampere per second. Its SI unit is Henry or Ohm second. Ohm second we are getting from L equals to E. E upon current means V upon I is ohm and into second. Ohm second. Dimension of L. We got L as in magnitude. L equals to E upon di by dt. So L equals to E dt upon di. And L is work done to move charge into dt upon di. This is I into t into dt upon di. So dimension of L will be work dimension M1, L2, T minus 2, dt is same as time t. I is A1, T, T1, A1. So we get this T and T will get cancelled. M1, L2, T minus 2, A minus 2. This is dimension of inductance L. Copy again.
Yes.
Self inductance of a long solenoid. What is formula for field at any point inside the solenoid? For a solenoid, what is magnetic field at any point inside? B, at any point inside is how much? Is it mu naught Ni, which we can write number of turns upon length into I? Are you remembering this formula?
Yes, sir.
Copy. We are interested in L. By finding flux, we can get L. And flux is area into field. See, this Friday you don't have lecture. Then coming Monday also you don't have lecture. Coming Wednesday also you don't have lecture. So there are three lectures to be compensated. Friday is first. So we'll resume then. Tomorrow you are free by any means, any time, so that one lecture of Friday I can adjust on Thursday. Hello, Friday free?
Free tomorrow.
What time you are free?
After 6 o'clock.
After 6 you are free. After 6 you are free. After 6. So can we have at 7 o'clock? 7 to 8?
Yes, I'm fine.
So tomorrow 7 to 8 extra class for you all. So Friday ka tension door ho gaya. Bhai Monday ka kal wapas sochte. Just complete till this.
Yes.
Done, na? So magnetic field at any point inside the solenoid of length L is mu naught number of turns upon length into I. The magnetic flux through each turn. Magnetic flux, we all know it is area into field. So can I say it is area into mu naught number of turns per unit length into I? Okay. Therefore, total flux through n turns of coil will be n times flux through one turn, which is n times mu naught n by l I into this area A. This I am writing small l to avoid confusion. Copy till this. Therefore, L equals to N phi upon current I, which will be mu naught N square I A length upon I. That is, L equals to mu naught N square A upon L. L is length, A is area, mu naught is permeability, and square, you know, it is nothing but number of tons square. Copy further. So self-inductance of solenoid is mu naught n square A upon L. Mu naught n square A upon L.
Yes.
10 times right in rough gauge. For solenoid, L is mu naught n square A upon L, mu naught n square A upon L. 10 times right, because very important formula. Derivation they may not ask, but MCQ they can ask. Mu naught n square A upon L, mu naught n square A upon L, mu naught n square A upon L. Mu naught n square A upon L. Mu naught n square A upon L. Written 10 times. Mu naught n square A upon L. Mu naught n square A upon L. Mu naught n square A upon L. Next, right. Energy stored in an inductor. Energy stored in an inductor. This one is an important one. By Faraday's and Lenz's law induced EMF in an inductor, comma E is minus L di by dt. But E is dW upon dq, we know by definition. Work done against the repulsive force is called EMF induced. Hello?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Actually, it is negative work done. Na? So we can write work done against the force. Work is negative. So from this, can I say dW upon dq is L di by dt. So dw is L dq by dt into di. What is dq by dt called as? Current. Dq by dt is called current. Hello? Dq by dt, is it called current?
Yes,
so dw we are getting L I di by I di. Now total work done will be energy stored. Copy. completed again.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, total work done to develop, or we can say send current from 0 to I, comma W is integral of dW from 0 to I. Therefore, L I DI from 0 to I, which is L I integration is I square by 2, 0 to I. So this L I square by 2 minus 0 square by 2. So W equals to L I square by 2. That is half L I square. So therefore, energy stored in an inductor, comma U, is half L I square. Copy.
Yes.
Now I'm doing MCQ from page number 498. Next lecture, this chapter will get over. Then we can start with AC circuit. So tomorrow we'll complete this chapter. Come to page number 498. First objective. Are you there on that page?
498.
Yeah, get it. Because when you read, you'll understand. If electromagnetic induction, charge induced does not depend upon. I first know formula for EMF induced as d phi by dt. But we are interested in charge, that means we require I dt. So by Ohm's law, E is nothing but IR d phi by dt. I dt will become d phi by R. I dt means charge induced, d phi by R. It depends upon flux, depends upon resistance. So can I say it is independent of time? From the formula, it is independent of time. Option B. Second. A rod moves at constant velocity in a direction perpendicular to the length. So if this is length of the rod, perpendicular to this, it is moving. In a space, there is magnetic field in a space in the direction perpendicular to rod as well as the velocity. So it will be inward. This is B bar. Select the correct statement. See here, B bar, L bar, V bar are mutually perpendicular. If they are mutually perpendicular, then EMF will be induced, which is given by B and B. And induced current direction of induced current is given by right Fleming's right hand rule. That means if I imagine three fingers of left hand now, outstretched mutually perpendicular to each other. Index finger is field, which is inside. Thumb is motion, which is upward. Middle finger is going to the left. Middle finger is going to the left. So this is induced current direction by Fleming's right hand rule. So wherever this current comes, that is becoming positive potential. And from wherever current has left, that is negative potential. So that means this entire arrangement actually behaves like battery, whose EMF is BLB, this is the meaning. So if this is battery, so there will be electric field from positive to negative throughout the wire. So answer is the entire rod is at same potential? No. There is electric field throughout the wire. Completed first and second.
Yes.
Okay, third, fourth, we'll see. The current through 1 millihenry drops from 5 ampere to 3 ampere in time 10^-3 second. EMF developed in the coil is how much? EMF is L di by dt in magnitude. L is 1 millihenry, so 10^-3. Change in current 5^-3 in time 10^-3 second. So equals to 2 volt. 2 volt is option C.
So
process.
Okay. Fourth one, when current in coil changes from 8 ampere to 2 ampere in time 3 into 10 raised to minus 2 second, EMF induced is 2 volt. What is self induction in milli Henry? So E is L di by dt. So 2 equals to L di is 8 minus 2 time 3 into 10 raised to minus 2. L is 6 into 10 raised to minus 2 upon 6. L is 10 raised to minus 2 Henry. That means 10 milli Henry. 10 milli Henry, option D. Self inductance of a straight conductor. That means turn is zero, na? Straight conductor means what is N? N is zero, correct? Hello? Self inductance formula is what? N phi upon I. So this will become zero because N is zero. A option. A coil and a bulb are connected in series. Bulb and coil are connected in series with DC source. DC source. When soft iron core is inserted in the coil, then light emerging from the bulb. See, light emerging from the bulb will dim or it will brighten depending upon power. And power will depend upon voltage. If voltage is changed, bulb will change its brightness or dimness. If not, then it will remain constant. For DC source, I is constant or variable? Is I constant? Hello? Is I constant?
Yes, sir.
So di upon dt will be zero. So EMF induced will be L di by dt, which is zero. Therefore, original and new voltages are same. Therefore, brightness will be same. Write down. Reason write down properly.
Yes, sir.
Seven. a solenoid L and resistance R. Solenoid L and resistance R are connected in series. When switch is put on, then current. Means there is not DC source, there is switch. So first current was zero, then switch is on, decaying current will flow. Because this will create induced EMF. So I formula is I zero e raised to minus lambda t. This is called decay current. So this is the graph. In AC circuit, we'll study in detail. Therefore, option C. Important for MCQ. Done?
Yes.
Come to page number 503. Numerical we are doing, first one. Simple chapter, see, people feel difficult, I don't know why. Area enclosed by circular coil of 2000 ton. Coil of 2000 ton. Area enclosed 10 centimeter square. So 10 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Is perpendicular to field of 0.3 Weber meter raised to minus 2. Rotated through angle of 180 degree. What is change in magnetic flux? Change in magnetic flux, that is V5. See. First case, plane of coil is perpendicular to the field. So I can say initial flux phi 1 equals to A into B. Into cos 0, that is AB. Final flux phi 2 is AB cos 180, which is minus AB. So total change in flux will be phi 1 minus phi 2, that is AB minus of minus AB, twice AB, area 10 raised to minus 3 into area 10 raised to minus 3 and B is 0.3. So it is 6 into 10 raised to minus 4 Weber. For fourth, this is for 1 ton. For 2000 tons, change in flux will be 2000 into 6 into 10 raised to minus 4. That is 1.2. Solve. See, they have given calculate change in magnetic flux. I mean, incomplete sum. Therefore, I found for 1 ton as well as for 2000 ton. come to second sum. Magnetic flux through the coil of 50 ton changes from 0.3 Weber to zero in time 1 second. Calculate induced EMF. Induced EMF is N times d phi by dt. That is 50 times 0.3 minus 0 upon dt 1. 5 into 3, 15 volt. This answer. 15 volt.
Yes.
Third one, a coil of area 0.5 meters square having 100 tons is placed perpendicular to the field of 0.04 Weber per meter square. If the coil is suddenly brought out, means finally field is zero. Suddenly brought out means field becomes zero in time 0.01 second. Calculate average EMF induced. EMF induced is d phi by dt, which is E equals to N d phi by dt. That is N B1 minus B2 into A upon dt. So N is 0.100, A is 0.5. B1 0.04, B2 0, 10 raised to minus 2. So this becomes 0.5 into 100, that is 50, into 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 upon 10 raised to minus 2. Cancel this, 10 raised to minus 2, 200 volt. Answer 200 volt. Completed?
Yes.
Fourth one, try on your own. What is the answer? Fourth one? Getting 0.75. Time is 30 milliseconds. Convert into second.
Calculate.
Easy, I think you should get.
Yes, sir.
0.75?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Okay. So next one, see. A ring has radius 10, resistance 2, field is changing, normal and changing at this rate, find induced EMF. So E will be area into dB by dt. Area for ring is pi r square into dB by dt. Pi is 3.14. 10 centimeter means 10 raised to minus 1. Square dB by dt is 10 raised to minus 1. 3.14 into 10 raised to minus 3 volt, 3.14 millivolt. I is E by R. E is 3.14 milli upon 2. So I equals to 1.57 milliampere.
Done, no?
Yes.
Completed?
Yes.
So, right, tomorrow.